a few scenes from today, the earthquake, and what led up to the earthquake. And indeed, we first became aware of it when we were watching ABC's coverage of what was to be the third game in the World Series this afternoon.
Allowing Jose Canseco to score, and he fails to get Dave Parker at second base, so the Oakland A's take
a I'll tell you what, we're having an earthquake.
But we were told by someone who was on the scene. You can see they didn't have a clue.
You're seeing a car that attempted to drive over this 50-foot gap in the Bay Bridge. It has been like a drama here. It has been dangling from the edge, the precipice behind me. And these folks are just getting rescued right now. It's been about an hour-long effort. It's been a frightening scene here. As you can see, just below me is where this crack in the Bay Bridge occurred, a 50-foot section. You see down there below the two cars that were on the upper deck when the bridge collapsed. They fell below. We understand that the people in both of those cars did get out safely. We do not know the extent of injuries at this point.
Again, you see the Marina District, the Jefferson Divisadero area, where these very expensive buildings have collapsed, and the fire continues as the San Francisco Fire Department tries to fight it. This was a four-story building, and that's the kind of problem. They are trying to evacuate people who may have been inside. A lot of people at home at that time or during the commute hour as the earthquake struck at 5:04 this afternoon in Northern California. We have an unofficial word, or it perhaps is official now. Seven people have died in this crash, including the one, or in this quake rather, including the one when an old building south of Market collapsed on people in automobiles. And there is one other death too, perhaps one on the Bay Bridge when that section of it collapsed. But here trying to get people out of their homes, some injuries, perhaps just panic as well. And this, if it indeed is the big one that we've heard so much about, and people trying to do whatever they can to stop the fire, but part of the problem, obviously, is gas.
Electricity, store water, prepare for aftershocks, prepare for 3 days of no services. You got 90 minutes of light left. You better make use of your time. Standing here ain't doing nothing.
This is what happened here when the quake hit. Burglar alarms were set off. The power lines were swaying. As I said, power was cut off.
Everything just started shaking, and it's a plaster and lath building, and just whole sheets of plaster were coming off the ceiling and the walls.
All the rubble and the pipes from the boiler all had fallen over, so we had to crawl over. And I held the baby so we could crawl over and hand the baby from one to another so we could crawl across the all the debris in the back.
You can see these cars that were squashed almost flat. These unfortunate people were just leaving work. They were getting into their cars. The quake hit, the bricks came down, and they really didn't have a chance. The best estimate at this moment is that four people are dead.
What you see, obviously, is a car crushed and burning as the road buckled and it collapsed. As you could see from the ground level pictures, the upper level of 880 collapsed on the lower.
There is a section here from 18th Street all the way up to 32nd Street, this section of the Nimitz. The upper freeway ramp collapsed onto the lower freeway ramp and sandwiched all the rush hour commuters, all the traffic in between. It's unbelievable, 14 city blocks of it. We had some of the rescue workers here describing things they saw in climbing up there and trying to rescue people. One of the descriptions was that they were walking wounded on top. They were taken away, that there was an 8-passenger van that they saw sandwiched to only about 2 or 3 feet high. They are pulling bodies out from underneath this lower ramp. There were just some injuries on the upper ramp, but those on the lower ramp, there are a lot of fatalities. Answering services are asking that all medical professionals, all doctors, please call your answering services.
They evacuated somewhere between 15 and 25,000 people from this airport tonight. When the earthquake hit, it was one of the peak times, as you know, 5 o'clock.
85,000 customers are without power just in the central San Jose area, Highway 17, Hamilton, and the East Foothills.
Most of the people here are saying that they'll tough it out through the night. They have no place else to go. At least, as I said, there is food here, there is water, and they feel safe.
Right in the front of every phone book throughout the Bay Area are very valuable tips about what to do after an earthquake hits. And you can see it's very easy to find. We hold it up for you there on what to do. Of course, the most important thing.
And that's going to be must reading in the Northern California area. Tragically tonight, a bad day for California. ABC News will be here to keep you up to date on developments on the earthquake in San Francisco as developments warrant throughout the night, with detailed reports on World News This Morning and Good Morning America, and a complete wrap-up on World News Tonight with Peter Jennings. That's our report for tonight. I'm Ted Koppel in Washington. For all of us here at ABC News, good night.
This has been Nightline.
This has been a presentation of ABC News, where more Americans get their news than from any other source.